This is fourth grade, module 3, lesson 14. And in this lesson, we begin to solve division word problems with remainders. Now, the key thing about this lesson is when we're talking about division, there's two different ways that students can think about division. And oftentimes in old textbooks, they treat these two methods as synonymous, as the same, as if it doesn't matter. But in this lesson, and I'm going to really make a big point on this, that there's two ways to think about division, partitive and measurement, and we're going to talk about that on the next slide. So as a teacher, I want you guys to really point out the two different kinds of division, and when you're writing your own homework assignments or your quizzes or your tests, make sure you include examples of both kinds of division.
So let's take a moment to talk about those two different kinds of division. So suppose we have, let's see, the problem 15 divided by 4. Two ways that we could think about that problem, we could think of it as partitive and we could think of it as measurement. So partitive, an example of partitive would be, let's see, 15 soccer balls sorted into 4 baskets. How many are in each basket? So the idea of the word partitive means we know we're taking these 15 and we're sorting them into 4 parts, into 4 buckets. An example of measurement would be we have the same 15 soccer balls, but now we're going to be placing them in groups of 4. So now we know the size of each group. We're wondering how many groups we need. So 15 soccer balls with 4 balls placed into each basket. How many baskets do we need? So two different examples. This lesson in particular, the concept development kind of bounces back and forth between both kinds of division. But it's interesting in that the homework almost exclusively is measurement. And that's a little on the messed up side, parents and teachers. We want to make sure we're doing both kinds of division, especially since we talk about both kinds of division in the concept development. But in the homework, all the homework problems are measurement. So let's get talking about some specifics here. So for example, 13 divided by 4. We can model this as partitive, and we can model this as measurement. And an example, or how we would do that, measurement. How we would do that? Well, let's see, 13 divided by 4 with the partitive means we're going to take 13 and we're going to cut it into 4 parts. So the idea would be we're going to take 1, 2, 3, 4 parts, and we're going to take those 13, and we're going to sort them evenly into those 4 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then we next one over would be 13, right? So that means we have 1 remainder. So the answer would be 13 divided by 4. 13 divided by 4 is 3. With 1 remainder, because there's 3 in each of the 4 groups. Now we could look at this and do it as measurement, which is we're going to say let's put 4 in each group. So we'd say 13 divided by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That constitutes a group. Now let's do 5. Well, that's a little thicker pen. 5, 6, 7, 8. That constitutes a group. We're going to keep going. That's 8. So 9, 10, 11, 12. That constitutes a group. Do we have enough to make another group? No. So there's our remainder. And so again, we can see that our answer, 13 divided by 4, is 3 remainder 1. Now what's the difference? Over here, right here, what we just did, 3 divided by 4, 4 is the size of each group, 3 is the number of groups. Over here, 3 tells you the, well, 4 tells you how many groups you need, and the 3 tells you how many are in each group. Both cases, we have 1 left over, and in both cases, you get 3 remainder 1. But boy, depending on how we're thinking of these problems, students may have a hard time talking to the teacher. They may have a hard time talking to each other, possibly because one kid is speaking from a partitive point of view while the other kid is trying to talk from a measurement point of view. And we want both students to understand they're both likely right. We don't need to make one kid feel wrong and the other kid feel right, or vice versa. So let's do this. So Linda makes booklets using 2 sheets of paper. She has 17 sheets of paper. How many of these booklets can she make? Will she have extra paper? How many sheets? Okay, so the idea would be we are going to do 17 divided by 2. Now, this says Linda makes booklets using 2 sheets of paper. Okay, so here's one sheet, that makes a booklet. One sheet, that makes a booklet. One sheet, that makes a booklet. Again, another booklet. See, how many booklets have we done? Well, let's count how many pieces of paper we've used. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I could go 13, 14, 15, 16. I don't have enough to make an entire booklet. Here's 17. And so there's our answer. So our answer is, how many booklets can she make? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So her answer is 8, remainder 1. So she can make 8 booklets, and she'll have 1 page left over. 1 sheet left over. All right. So this is an example of measurement, because we know how many are in each group, and that it's a matter of counting how many groups we need. Another example, and I believe this one is also measurement technique. So this says Miss Rochelle wants to put her 29 students into groups of 6. How many groups of 6 can she make? So the idea is she's going to do 29 divided by 6. But in this case, the groups have 6 in each of them. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's one group. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's another group. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. That's another group. 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. That's another group. 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. That's not quite a whole group. So what have we done? Well, we've got 1 group, 2, 3, 4 groups. So her answer is 4 with a remainder of 5. So if she puts the remaining, so how many groups can she make? She can make 4 groups of 6 kids. And then the remaining is 1 group of 5 that are left over. And again, another example, and a third example where it's a measurement version of division. So we've got Melissa, and she has 43 toy soldiers, and she lines them up in rows of 5 to fight imaginary zombies. How many of these rows can she make? After making as many rows of 5, she puts the remaining soldiers in the last row. How many soldiers are in that last row? So basically, we're going to do rows of 5, and we're going to make 43, up all the way up to 43. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 30, 35, 40, 41, 42, 43. So how many rows did she make? She made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So she did 43 divided by 5. She got 8 rows. plus she has a remainder of three. So we have three little guys left over down there. All right. So as we wrap things up, I'm going to just belabor the point a little bit, because teachers, I really want us to be thoughtful about the division. That when you do a division problem, you've got two kinds, partitive and measurement. Make sure that when you are providing your students practice, you're giving them plenty of experience with both kinds of division. And quite frankly, this lesson didn't include a whole lot of both kinds. It was mostly measurement. And that wraps up me being pretty negative, and I don't mean that. Module 4, lesson 3, no, 4th grade, module 3, lesson 14.